Hey guys, Austin here with 715 Tactical. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be going over my top 3 favorite EDC holsters. When it comes to everyday carry, I'm a huge fan of inside the waistband, so that's what we're going to be covering today. Before we dive into these holsters, we got to give a huge shout out to our channel sponsors. Black Dot Ammunition. Black Dot is always nice enough to send out the ammo that you see me shooting in my reviews. If you're looking for some readily available ammo, still at a decent price during the national ammo apocalypse, make sure you check these guys out. And you can also use my discount code 715TACTICAL at checkout to save some money on your order. They restock their inventory every Tuesday and Thursday morning, but make sure you get there pretty early, as the stuff tends to fly off the shelves fairly quick. I recently made the switch over to Shooter Lube versus your traditional smelly gun cleaners. Shooter Lube is a two-stage weapon cleaning system. You start off with the solvent and then move to the lubrication. Made right here in the United States and eco-friendly, if you guys are looking to make the switch just as I did, go ahead and use that discount code 715TACTICAL at checkout to save some money on your order. Let's dive in. When it comes to picking a holster for your everyday carry setup, I'm sure it can seem overwhelming. It seems almost everybody and their grandmother is making a holster these days. So how do you pick what's right for you? Well, you have to take a few things into consideration. First off, your firearm, your environment that you're usually in, the accessories on your firearm, and it even comes down to the style of clothes that you wear. It all plays a huge factor. Let's start off with the Sidekick IWB by Gerber Holsters. The Sidekick is an inside-the-waistband carry holster designed to be comfortable for all-day carry without compromising sturdiness or reliability. All of Gerber's products are built with incredible precision to offer a smooth draw and reholster every single time. The Sidekick is going to come with a concealment claw that pulls your firearm snug against your body for deeper concealment. I'm a huge fan of the claw. When I first started carrying inside the waistband, I was a little skeptical about the claw. It just seemed unnecessary to me, and it seemed like it took up very valuable space. After using them for a while, I did notice a difference. It really does aid in concealment. Some people will call these a claw, some people will call them a mod wing. You know, it's a horse apiece. The Sidekick is going to come with your standard foamy clip, which stands for fold over molded injection. It's one of the most popular clips you're going to see on an IWB holster. Now the cool thing about this, it has an adjustable cant, so you can adjust the angle that your holster sits at. The Sidekick is also built with Gerber's specialty spacers that allow for retention adjustability. You know, it helps you master your draw. Personally, the Sidekick is one of my favorite holsters that I own for inside the waistband carry. I found absolutely no issues with the Sidekick from Gerber, and I am 100% comfortable using this on a daily basis as part of my EDC setup. If you guys want to pick one of these up from Gerber's website, go ahead and use that discount code on the bottom of the screen, and you can also find it pinned in the first comment down in the comment section. I have my holster set up for a Glock 19 with a Trijicon RMR, suppressor height sights, a compensator, and a Surefire X300 weapon light. With all this stuff added on this firearm, it's a pretty beefy package. Now keep in mind, I'm a bigger individual. I'm about 210 pounds, 5'11", and I have no problem concealing this firearm, even with my bigger dad bod. Gerber Holsters, you guys did a phenomenal job. Keep up the good work. Let's move on to G-Code Holsters. G-Code is no stranger to the two-way community when it comes to holsters. This one in particular is going to be their Incog Shadowy Clips, and this is endorsed by Haley Strategic. If you're not familiar with Haley Strategic, I highly encourage you to jump online and type them into Google. This is going to be another light-bearing holster. Light-bearing meaning that this holster is able to accept the firearm with a weapon light on it. Now these are designed and created to be specific to a certain weapon light. They're not universal. And that's how you get that phenomenal retention. The Incog Shadowy Clips is going to come with a base MSRP of around $80. My Incog Shadowy Clips is set up for a Glock 19 with a Trijicon RMR, suppressor height sights, and a Streamlight TLR 1HL weapon light. It's a rarity that I'm going to carry anything else besides a Glock 19. I guess you could kind of say I'm a Glock fanboy. I become very proficient with a Glock, and it's what I use the majority of the time when I train. Just like the Sidekick from Gerber Holsters, the Incog Shadowy Clips does have adjustable retention. That's going to give you that nice audible click when you feed your firearm into that holster. The Shadowy Clips is offered as a single clip design to minimize print. I know there's a lot of people out there that don't believe in the single clip, but I will tell you, this is highly effective and it did not fail me once in my test and evaluation. I've used this holster for everyday carry for around the past 2 months and I have had no issues whatsoever. It's very sturdy and stays very secure on your gun belt. I would highly recommend this holster. I'm a big fan of G-Code products and I always have been. And this holster definitely doesn't disappoint. What's cool about this holster is that it's not your traditional Kydex. In a sense, it is and it isn't. You have your standard Kydex on the inside and a black tactical fuzz on the outside. I've never really seen the black tactical fuzz before until I started using G-Code IWB holsters. It's kind of cool, it's very comfortable. You just have to check it out for yourself. These do come in a few different color selections and you also have different options for clip length. It's nice to have that versatility. I would highly recommend that you check out this G-Code Incog Shadow Eclipse if you're looking for a great light-bearing holster. Let's move on to the Phenom Stealth by G-Code Holsters. The Phenom Stealth is going to come with a base MSRP of around $100. Now this is a pretty cool holster. The Phenom Stealth is a superior quality, feature-rich concealed carry solution for the most discriminating user. The Phenom Stealth is adaptable for strong side, appendix, or cross-draw carries. The distinctive Moclaw is CNC machined from 6061 and is hard-code anodized. It's low weight, streamlined, and with superior strength, this apparatus ensures that your holster and weapon will always be tucked tight to your body. Remember when we were talking over Gerber holsters and we were talking about the mod wing or the claw? This is exactly that. The Moclaw is a tension device designed to press against the wearer's belt in order to drive the butt of the weapon into the body for maximum concealment. Just like the Incog Shadow Eclipse, the Phenom Stealth also features the tactical fuzz. Not only is it on the outside of the holster, but it also lines the inside, which is going to deliver a whisper quiet draw and a functional impression like no other. You know, this holster does a phenomenal job at minimizing printing. And one of the hardest things to overcome with everyday carry is firearm printing. I can't stress that enough. And I also can't count on my hands how many times I've been in public and I can just tell people are carrying firearms because the printing is that bad. It totally defeats the purpose of concealed carry if you're gonna let people know that you have a concealed firearm. One thing that I really like about this holster is gonna be the clip. It is very solid and durable. When it comes down to the Moclaw, you are able to choose the Moclaw and screw color. It's cool to have that versatility. And I will say, I am a huge fan of this red on black setup. Once again, this is a very capable inside the waistband holster for everyday carry. If you guys are in the market, I would highly recommend that you check out any of the three holsters that we discussed in this episode. I hope you're able to take something away from this video. Guys, as always, thank you for stopping in. Stay vigilant, and I will see you next time.